and wondering if one day you will become a coronavirus statistic. As many of you are still young, you certainly don't want to be that person who becomes part of a news article that contains words such as, "young healthy person dies after COVID-19 infection." That is highly unlikely, and statistically speaking, even if you did get infected, you'd very likely be okay if you are young and reasonably healthy. You're practicing social distancing, you wash your hands regularly, but could you still get it? Today, we'll see how that could happen. Okay, so you're sitting at home, but your food stocks are low and you need to go out and buy some things. Let's imagine you're in the local store, and even though you're trying to keep your distance from people, that's not always possible when a few people are trying to buy tins of tuna in the same aisle. Some guy reaches out to grab a can, and so do you at the same time, but then this guy coughs right in your face. This guy is actually carrying the virus. He just doesn't know it yet because he feels fine. The chances are you will now become infected. In fact, if you look at what the World Health Organization has to say, even if this guy exhales on you, you might get infected from him. The reason is because very small droplets of the virus have been emitted from him, and they have reached you and entered your eyes, nose, or mouth. This is why health officials are asking people to stay 6 feet away from other people when out in public. You might wonder, does the disease hang around in the air? Is it airborne? Meaning, could this guy's droplets wait around for someone else? The WHO says the droplets are too heavy to hang around in the air. But other research tells us that smaller particles might remain airborne for as long as 3 hours. We don't know right now how likely it is that you could become infected by those smaller airborne particles. A recent article in the journal Nature said the experts disagree on this point. So let's move on and just say you got a direct hit from this guy in the store. Let's now say you were wearing a mask when you came into contact with the guy. Would that mask have protected you? This has been a matter of controversy, but the majority of health officials around the world are now saying you should wear a mask. You see, what if that guy who coughed or even exhaled on you had been wearing a mask? He didn't want to wear one, seeing as he was feeling fine. The thing is, though, if he had been wearing a mask, those tiny droplets very likely wouldn't have hit you. One of the reasons why the Center for Disease Control and Prevention said not everyone had to wear a mask, such as one of those N95 respirators, was because it wanted to ensure healthcare workers had enough of them. As we write this, the CDC says it is reviewing its guidelines regarding mask wearing. Most experts now agree that you should wear a mask just in case you are asymptomatic. If you don't have one at hand, a homemade mask is better than nothing. A study at Cambridge University and another study in China demonstrated that making a DIY mask from clothing or even paper towels can work. So far, data shows that countries where mask wearing is very common seem to be coping with the spread a bit better. Masks have made a comeback. As we write this, the news is telling us that Amazon is going to give all its workers masks. The British medical journal The Lancet also recently said universal use of face masks could be considered if supplies permit. We went to the CDC website and read this. If you are caring for others, if the person who is sick is not able to wear a face mask, for example, because it causes trouble breathing, then as a caregiver, you should wear a face mask when in the same room with them. What does that tell you? It tells you that you can protect yourself by wearing a mask. We should add, though, that masks are not an ironclad guarantee that you won't get the virus. The experts say those droplets can be transmitted through the eyes, and those very small droplets can penetrate some masks. Still, the word on Expert Street is by wearing a mask, your chance of getting the virus is reduced. Okay, so let's say you actually do have your mask on, and you even keep 6 feet away from that guy who wants the same brand of tinned tuna. You wait behind him, and then go in and grab your can. What you've just done is touched a surface that now has the coronavirus particles on it. You then don't bother washing your hands with soap and water or dousing them with an alcohol-based hand wash. Without doing that, you might then touch your mask, and then you've just transmitted the virus to that mask. You might also touch your face since some part of it is itching, and that's another way you could get infected. Now, it all gets a bit complicated because we need to know how long the virus can stay on surfaces and how much of it is needed to infect a person. The New England Journal of Medicine recently published a study about how long the virus can hang around on certain surfaces. In a laboratory, the researchers tested different surfaces, and the results were that it can stay on plastic and steel for up to 72 hours. They found it can stay on copper for up to 4 hours, and it can stay on cardboard for up to 24 hours. Another researcher said it depends on how many particles of the virus are on that surface you touch. So if that guy has only just coughed on a tuna can, then the virus will likely be more intact. But as you know, the virus can't stand around forever. so after a while, there will be less of it on a surface. The best thing you can do is wash your hands after you've touched a surface in public, and especially those known as high-touch surfaces, things like doorknobs. Right now, though, scientists are saying there's a much bigger chance of getting infected person to person than from touching a surface that has coronavirus particles on it. Let's now say that you didn't go out and buy any tuna, but you had it delivered. Well, your groceries might come in a cardboard box, and as you already know, the virus can hang around on that box. You might touch it and then later touch your face. The same goes for items in that box. Some of them might have the virus on them. The experts say that this is an unlikely scenario as to how you might become infected. But if you want to be safe, you should discard packages and then wash your hands. You might also use household detergents to regularly wash down surfaces in your house. One of the reasons for this is because you might not live alone, and someone else might have touched a surface outside that had particles on it and then brought it into the home and put some on a doorknob. They didn't bother washing their hands, and then they opened the door and touched lots of other surfaces. This is another way you could become infected, but as we said, the experts say person-to-person transmission is much more likely. We keep saying this because we don't want to scare you, we just want to describe to you some worst-case viable scenarios. If someone in your house does get it, well, then you might be in trouble. The reason is they might not show any symptoms. In fact, they might not ever show symptoms. As far as we can see, scientists are still not sure why this is. But you might not be as fortunate. And so, let's say you're watching TV with your little infected brother and he coughs and exhales on you. And then you might get it. That's why people are being told to stay at home for the time being. So folks, don't bring the virus home with them and spread it to others. You might just really get unlucky and trip at home and break your arm. This will mean you'll have to take a trip to the hospital. Hospitals are, of course, going to great lengths to stop the virus spreading in them, but as you know, they can be busy places. It might be difficult not to touch a contaminated surface or even stay out of the way of an asymptomatic person whose arm is also broken. It's the same with other places where lots of people tend to go, like airports or government offices. That's the reason so many places are closing, or at least slowing down and implementing sensible prevention measures. Someone might also cough on you and leave droplets on your clothes. So if you go out in public and get very close to people, you might want to not only wash your hands, but wash your clothes too. We don't exactly know how long the virus can stay on clothes, and that's a matter that's still being researched. But some scientists are saying that the droplets may dry out faster on natural materials. A former CDC chief medical officer said clothes might catch the virus particles, but then they'll dry out and be broken apart. The National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease said this could be the case, but then you have clothes such as leather that's not so porous. You also have buttons and zippers and other non-porous clothing, so it might be a good idea to give things a wash and maintain that hand-washing regimen. Maybe you have all the food you need. But let's say you go to the laundromat. Well, in that case, you might also come into contact with infected people or surfaces that have the virus particles on them. You could even disinfect the washing machine with a cleaning product or an alcohol solution, although it's likely someone has been doing that already. You could be extra careful and wear rubber gloves and then discard them after you're done at the laundromat. Wash your hands, of course, after you've taken off the gloves. Also, be mindful of what you touch with your gloves. Some people, of course, have no choice but to go to work where many others work, such as at those Amazon facilities. If that's the case, you might want to wash your clothes after every workday. Okay, you're doing all of this, but then you need to go out and get some cash. Well, as you know, those virus particles could have been transferred to the buttons of the cash machine, and then you go and touch your face. Drawing out cash could give you the coronavirus if you touch your face before you've washed your hands. But what about the money itself? Not the dollars you just took from the machine, but the ones you just received along with some coins after you bought that tin of tuna. Well, shiny, hard surfaces can be contaminated, so that also means coins. Dollars can also be infected, and this is why right now you'll see staff in stores wearing gloves. It's why some stores around the world are no longer accepting cash payments. So yeah, handling money could be a problem for you. It's also another reason you are now seeing hand sanitizers in just about every store. But let's say you wash your hands, but you've put those coins and dollars in your wallet. Well, if the virus can stay on surfaces like dollars and coins, then it could stay on them in your wallet. You could always disinfect those coins and dollars with an alcohol solution, and this might sound over the top to you, but the experts say cash can contain virus particles on it. If you want to be safer, you can disinfect all your money. We actually found a foreign exchange firm that was doing this with all of its banknotes and banks in China. They actually started disinfecting money using ultraviolet or heat treatments. Maybe disinfecting money isn't actually that over the top. Contactless payments might be a better idea. but we should say that the World Health Organization has so far not said that we should be disinfecting our money. And remember, this virus does not penetrate your skin. You have to transfer it to places like your eyes, nose, and mouth. So that's the end. You've heard how you might become infected, but you've also heard a lot about how to prevent yourself from becoming infected. We hope all of you will be safe and not become a statistic. Keep staying inside and watch what is it actually like to have COVID-19, and why Spanish flu killed over 50 million people, deadliest plague in modern history. See you next time!